Hey guys, it's Melanie. Happy Tuesday and welcome back to my channel. I am obviously behind the camera here. Welcome back to my bathroom. It's been a very long time since I've done this particular video, but I thought I would do it because we are now in the month of October and my skincare has changed a little bit from the summer months. So I'm gonna take you guys through my initial fall transitional skincare that I'm gonna be using. So before we do get into it, I will put links to like my favorites down in the description box down below, but I'm not gonna be able to link everything because there's honestly just too much stuff. And also, here's the thing. You don't need all these things. There's always comments. I'm just trying to like preempt them right now. Realize this is a lot of stuff. I don't use everything on my face during every single routine. I have a morning routine and a night routine. There are certain products that I just use in the morning, certain products I just use in the evening. And no, not everything goes on my face at once. You know, I will use a cleanser, a toner, a serum or two, a specific treatment. I also use tretinoin. I have a couple different moisturizers that I like to go between. So I say all this just to let you know that I know this is a lot of stuff. I don't need comments on that. So anyway, I'm gonna just show you guys what I have and tell you sort of the method behind my madness of picking these things. So let's get into it. We're gonna start over here with my cleansers. The cleansers that I have pulled out right now for myself are the Dermatology Essential Cleanser in my shower for the morning time. So I use this in the evening. In the morning, I'm using the Derma-E, it's their alkaline like foaming cleanser. I'll link it down below. It's super gentle. Great way to start my skincare routine in the mornings. Love that one. The current like makeup remover or balm or whatever you want to call it that I'm using right now is the, and I love this stuff. I actually just pulled out a backup of it. It is the Strivectin Multi-Action Moisture Matrix Melting Cleanser. This is fabulous. If you've never tried it, it's wonderful. I live for this stuff. This came in my last Babor Times Skin Store collaboration box. This is the Clean Performance Clay Cleanser. You can also use this as a mask. I've been using it as a cleanser. I like it. It's obviously not foaming. It's kind of like just rubbing a clay mask on your skin, but it does definitely get some excess oil out of the skin, and it's nicer than just leaving something like that on. So this I've only used a little bit of, but I really like it so far. I think I might actually want the full size of this. This is the Babor Enzyme Cleanser. It is a powder product, so you pour it into your hand, and then you mix it with some water, and you use it to cleanse the skin. I'll use this maybe like once or twice a week. It's not something I would use on a daily basis. And then I also have the Derma-E Gentle Enzyme Peel. This is another great exfoliator that I would use like once a week. You just need a little bit. You rub it on your skin and it helps to exfoliate. It's a really nice product. It just kind of, like I said, polishes and evens the skin tone a little bit. It's really great. Okay, I'm gonna move you guys here this direction so that we can get a look at the devices that I'm currently using. So we'll go through this tiered tray here in a second. I am still using the droplets device. I'm putting my little used cartridges in this container here. Those are recyclable, so you send them back to the company. So I'm just getting a bunch together and then I'll send it back. I'm still using the Even Skin Lumo. I use the Even Skin Lumo on my neck. And I am using the Tripolar Stop VX on my face, mostly just my jawline. I love this. I also like the Even Skin Lumo. That one has some more features to it, but if you're just looking for radio frequency and DMA, this one is fantastic as well. It just honestly, it depends on what you're looking for. Are you looking for all the stuff that this offers, or are you just looking for this? Both, I think, are great devices. I love both. I would definitely repurchase either one if I lost them or if something happened to them. So there's that. This is my blue light therapy. I don't use this as often, especially during the fall months. This helps to control excess sebum, helps if I'm dealing with breakouts. Blue light is great for that. I do have my Mito Pro panel next to my bed. So I am still doing red light therapy as well. And I'm doing that about 3 days a week now. Love it. Will never ever give that up. The blue light I don't need quite as much. So that one is just there just in case. So those are the devices over here. Now let's start at the top here. Actually, I'm going to hold you guys for this. So this three-tier tray it's just from Hobby Lobby. We don't have a medicine cabinet in this bathroom. It's the only thing that I don't love about our bathroom setup here. But someday if we redo this bathroom, I would totally consider taking these big mirrors out and just doing some big medicine cabinets. Anyway, yeah, my hair's purple. You'll see this later on this week. Anyway, okay, so I have in here, this is just an old Nest candle. I have some eye creams in here that I'm testing out. So the 5 stars from Sunday Riley. I've got the Babor Lifting RX eye cream for the day. I'm not really like actively testing these two right now. I'll show you the one that I'm actively testing here in a second, but I have these in here just as like something different to use when I get bored. There's also a City Beauty Eye Revive Firming Serum in here as well. And then I do use lash conditioners. My two favorites are the Hair LaVie and then also the City Lash from City Beauty. Those are great. Toners that I have in here, I have the Daily Turnover Peel Pads from Noonie. These are okay, but honestly, I much prefer my Dr. Dennis Gross peel pads. So I wouldn't repurchase this one, but it's okay. I'm loving my Maysama Green Rooibos Gentle Resurfacing Toner. Love that. I actually use this on my arms. It's the Glycolic Exfoliating Toner from Good Molecules. The Isntree Green Tea Fresh Toner. Love this right before the red light therapy. This feels really weird being in the back. Hey. And then I still have this in here, although I'm not really using it much. It's the Vitamin C toner from, I'm having a brain fart. Who's this from? Rodeo, that's right. Anyway, it's nice. I just haven't like actively used it. Down here on this level, I'm gonna see if I can set you guys down. This might make it a little bit easier for me. Okay. So this level is just retinols, obviously my Retin-A, stuff like that. So let's go through it. My tretinoin, I use 0.5%, love it. I have family that goes to Mexico for vacations quite frequently, so I just ask them to pick that up for me in the pharmacies down there because it's way less expensive than purchasing it in the pharmacy here. So little tip, if you ever go visit Mexico, this is basically over the counter. You can just buy it. You don't need a prescription like you do here. Paula's Choice Resist BHA 9, always a go-to for me. Also, my Lumify drops, love those. I did purchase the full size of this, you guys. I'm taking one for the team, and I found it on sale, and then there was some decent cash back off with Rakuten. So I did buy the U Beauty Resurfacing Compound. Woo! Spent well over, what was it, like 100 and, I think I got it on, I got the 1 ounce on sale for like $125, I think. And then there was like 10% cash back. Still, spendy, but hope she's worth it. I certainly think it's worth it just based off of this sample that I had. So, I don't know. I blew the money on it, so you don't have to. I'll test it out. Okay, X-Linea Peptide Smoothing Serum from PCA Skin. Very curious about PCA skincare, so I'm starting with this. I also have a cleanser from them that I'll probably get out at some point this month. I'm really actively testing the High Potency Growth Factor Firming and Lifting Serum from Paracone MD. By the way, spoiler, Costco has this for a really great price, but you have to get it online. I'll link this at Costco down below, but you can also get it at places like Skin Store, obviously Sephora, wherever you can purchase Paracone MD, you can get that. So there's that. This is the Dr. Zenobia Inflammaging Night Repair Treatment. This is sometimes what I will use on my face on nights when I'm not using tretinoin and I just want like an over-the-counter retinol. But honestly, this kind of stuff is not strong enough for me. I'm trying to use this one up. It's a nice product. I think if you prefer Bakuchiol, this is a great one to check out. This line is specifically designed towards those with hormonal acne issues. So if that's you, check out Dr. Zenobia. She's got great products. I have my Mesama Green Rooibos Pressed Serum here. This I love. Also, I will apply this and actually sometimes these two together before I do my red light therapy. And then I usually wait about a half hour before I actually get in front of the panel. This really, I think, makes a difference in terms of making the red light therapy even more effective. At least that's what I've found for myself. I do have the Dermadoctor Picture Porefect. I struggle with that one. This is a great pore minimizer. I like to use this during the daytime. It does kind of act as a little bit of a primer for me, so that's nice. I don't think I'm supposed to show that yet. I'm testing this out for for a company. I don't think you're supposed to see that yet. So anyway, look at what we have here. We have the Dermalogica Bio Luminancy Gel Moisturizer. This is brand new from Dermalogica. I do love their Bio Luminancy Vitamin C Serum. I purchased like a mega size of that at one point, finished it. It's a great vitamin C serum in my eyes. And they recently reached out and said, hey, do you want to try this? And I said, sure, why not? I liked your serum, so. And the serum, by the way, I bought myself. So, but this they did send to me, so I'm enjoying it so far. It's a nice moisturizer. I have the Medicate. It's basically a hyaluronic acid serum. Sorry, I should get it into the frame. This is their Hydrate B5 Liquid Rehydration Serum. I think this is nice. This was honestly just a free sample that I got with an order. You can see I'm almost done with it. I like this, but I don't know, hyaluronic acid serum, I feel like I can use lots of different ones, and they're usually, most of them are pretty good. Advanced Snail 96 Mucin Power Essence, because yeah, I live for this stuff. You guys know how I feel about it. And I do have these collagen vials from Babor as well that came in the Skin Store times Babor collaboration, which by the way is still for sale if you're interested. On the bottom is where I keep my masks. So for this time of year, I love my honey potion from Pharmacy. I just did this last night, the Green Rooibos Brightening Mask from Mesama. Still loving this, so kept it out. After the summer, the Dr. Loretta Tightening Detox Mask. I will typically do masks once, sometimes twice a week, and then sheet masks I will also do throughout the week. I don't actually have very many sheet masks pulled right now, but my favorite are the City Beauty Hydro masks. Those are fantastic. I also have the Ultimate Moisturizing Honey Overnight Mask from COSRX. This is just like a moisturizer. I love using this one on my neck and my décolletage. I do have the Dr. Dennis Gross Clinical Grade Resurfacing Liquid Peel two-step process here that I love to do once a week sometimes. Well, usually this time of year, I'll go to like once every other week. That's usually plenty. This I'm almost done with. This was my free birthday gift from Sephora, either last year or the year before. It's the Proteiny Polypeptide Cream. I like this moisturizer. I think it's nice. I'm just honestly trying to finish it up because I'm trying to finish up a bunch of things that I have open. Still kept these moisturizers out because they're still working pretty great for me right now, but I will get heavier moisturizers here in a little while. This is the Hanacure Nano Emulsion, fantastic. If you're looking for something more affordable, do try the Isntree Green Tea Fresh Emulsion, also a great moisturizer for oily skin. Still loving this on my neck, the Ultra Firming Dry Oil from City Beauty. I have the, this was actually a gift that was given to me by someone. It was one of the times that Penn and I met up, by the way. So I did get this from Penny over at Penn's My Skincare. She gifted this to me. It is the Sculpla Sculpla. Oh God, I don't know how to say that. Anyway, it is their Promoter Repair Cell Cream. I've been using this for a number of months now. This is a pretty expensive product, you guys. I really like it. It does have snail mucin in it. It has that kind of weird texture that you also get with the COSRX. I love this. Again, it's really spendy. So I don't know that I'll probably do a worth the splurge on that once I finish it. I still have a little ways to go. It's a pretty decent size. So anyway, big thanks to Penny for gifting that to me. I didn't know anything about the brand. So, and this is my skincare fridge here. By the way, I do still sometimes use the W Skin device. I actually used this last night. I like it a lot. It's basically like a aquafacial, but you do it at home. I don't know. Some people don't like this particular device because it can, if you have very sensitive skin, if you're prone to rosacea, if you're prone to broken capillaries on your face, I would not use anything like this, but I don't really deal with that. So, it cleans out my pores really, really well. It's almost like a Biore pore strip, but it sucks everything out of your face. So anyway, still using that. And then in my skincare fridge, there's just some random things. I've got my Gua Sha device things in here that I like to leave in here. This I use every single, I still love this. I need to replace it soon. I'm almost done. My Paula's Choice Clinical 20% Niacinamide Treatment. I will never be without this. This is the eye cream that I am like solidly testing out right now. So these other guys are just kind of on days where I'm getting bored with this. But this is the MZ Skin Soothe and Smooth Eye Cream. She's spendy, but I did get this in a recent skin store. Which bag was this? I think it might be the Expert's Choice. If that bag is still available, you should think about it because this is really nice. Anyway. The Lightstim Photo Serum. I do still use this sometimes when I'm doing my red light therapy, but not as often. This did come with my Lightstim device. I have some oils in here. I've got the Propolis Ultralight Ampoule from COSRX. Oh my gosh, you guys, I still have this in here. This was Mr. Kong's ear meds. I guess I can get rid of that now. The last time that he had an ear infection, I just kept them up here because, anyway, it doesn't matter. I'm so sad. I miss my dog so much, you guys, I can't even begin to tell you. If you don't know, Mr. Kong passed away back in June. So, and then I also have the Propolis Light Ampoule here. This one is much lighter. This one's a little heavier. I actually prefer this one in the fall and this one in the summertime, but I'll continue to use both. Also in here, I do have the CCC Plus Ferulic Brightening Complex from Perricone MD. I haven't used a ton of this. I actually really like this product, but I think I forget about it being in here in the fridge. So what I need to do is just remember to pull this out because I guess the only other vitamin C product that I'm using is the Biolumin C Gel Moisturizer, but I do actually like this product. I just need to use it a little bit more. My beloved Centella Aqua Soothing Ampoule from COSRX. If you have easily irritated skin, you need to look into this because this will calm it right down. And I know, I realize I've been talking for a really long time. I just looked at the timer here. These are a couple of Perricone MD products that I'm also using. This is the Cold Plasma Plus. I use this on my face at night. It's way too rich for me to use during the daytime. And then I also have the Cold Plasma Plus Sub-D Neck. I need to start using this again. I kind of stopped when I was really testing out the City Beauty Ultra Firming Dry Oil, but I think I want to actually start using these two together and see if it makes my neck meat look even better. So anyway, you guys, that's what I have for my skincare for the fall here. By the way, I highly recommend getting a skincare fridge. This one is from Vanity Planet, but you can get them from lots of different places. You don't have to get this one. It's nice. I was actually thinking about looking at buying potentially a slightly bigger one. Really love having a skincare fridge. So if you have a slightly larger one or if you have a skincare fridge that you like, will you let me know which one you have? Because I think I might pass this one along to my sister-in-law potentially, and then get myself a slightly bigger mama jama. Anyway, this is what I have in my skincare routine for October. I might be adding some things in here or taking some things out. Like if I really don't like something, then I'll take it out and replace it with something else. Otherwise, I'm still trying to make a solid effort in terms of like testing specific things. So like, you know, products that contain peptides, resurfacing products, things like that. Anyway, hopefully this was helpful. Let me know what products you are incorporating into your skincare routine for the fall. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care. Toodaloo.